following program is made possible with the assistance of a grant from S&H Green Stamps.
These are scallops, Coquilles St. Jacques. Scallops simmered in wine with mushrooms and gratinade in their shells. That's today's recipe on the French Chef. Welcome to the French Chef. I'm Julia Child, and here are raw scallops. Scallops in French are called coquille Saint-Jacques. Coquille means shell, and Saint-Jacques was the apostle Saint James, who, according to legend, was buried in Santiago de Compostela in Spain. In the Middle Ages, pilgrims from all over the world visited his grave, and when they came back, they were entitled to wear this little coquille or shell in their bonnets. And so in France, they always call scallops coquille Saint-Jacques. That's a nice little story. Now, here are our scallops, and they look like this. They're sweet as a nut when fresh, as they ought to be. And if you buy them in a frozen package, be sure that there's no block of frozen water at the bottom of the package, which shows they've been defrozen and refrozen. But they freeze very well, and you can always tell by smelling them. They should just smell good enough to eat just as they are. We're going to do two recipes today. We're going to do some of the small scallops like this. These are not capes. Bay scallops, which are very nice and twice as expensive. These are just large scallops cut up into small pieces, and we will sauté them. Now, the large scallops like this, if you're going to do them in the coquille Saint-Jacques, you just slice them like that, because you don't want the pieces to be too large. And we're going to stew them in wine with mushrooms. So we just put them into a nice pot, and then we have sliced mushrooms to go with them. Here are our mushrooms. These, you remember how to slice mushrooms. You just, after you've washed them and dried them, you just do like that. You don't have to peel them at all, and the stem, you just slice like that. And then the mushrooms go in with the scallops. I've got about a cup and a half of scallops and about a cup and a half of mushrooms here. And then I'm going to put in some white wine or white vermouth. I always use white vermouth, and I'm going to put in about 2/3 of a cup. And then put in just a little tiny bit of water. As these stew, they exude some juice. So we don't want to have too much water, because we're going to use this nice liquid to make our sauce with. And then put in a bit of salt. I'm going to put in about a quarter teaspoon, and a little pepper. And then we're going to have some herbs along with, just cook with them. I'll move this out of the way. And we want some parsley and a bay leaf, and we'll just fold the bay leaf and the parsley like that and tie them together with white string so they're easy to remove. This is what's known as a partial bouquet garni, or herb bouquet. If it were a full one, it would also have thyme with it. And then we're going to put in either some shallot, that's a shallot, or green onion. Or the green onion or scallion can always substitute for shallot. And just chop it up fine like that. And then in that goes along with our scallops. And those just have to come up to the simmer and be covered, and I'll just toss them a little bit so that they get all the wine along with in them. And they get covered and will just be simmered very slowly for about 5 minutes. And while they're simmering, I'll put them back on the back burner. We're going to do some sautéed scallops. Now here are our sautéed scallops. Now these, you always dredge lightly with flour before you sauté them. But before you dredge them, you put on some salt and pepper. We're going to see how quickly this goes. That's just enough scallops for two people. And a little bit of salt. I never go with that idea of tossing everything in a paper bag, because I like to be sure that I've got all the salt and pepper on. But you can do any system that you like to do. And then put the flour on and stir that around with a rubber spatula. And then to get off the excess flour, and be sure that they're all covered, you just pour them into a sieve. And shake the sieve. And there you've gotten rid of all your excess flour. You only want to do the flouring just before you're going to sauté, because if you put it on too soon, it all gets gooey and hurried. Now you can sauté these either in olive oil, which I'm going to do, which is, these are sauté a la Provençal. Provençal means always oil and garlic. We're going to have some garlic in them too. You have to get your oil good and hot. I'm using, as usual, one of these no stick'em frying pans. I like it because you can shake it back and forth and it has a high enough lip. Now, you want to be sure that you've gotten your oil hot, so you just have to wait. And it's a little hard sometimes to tell whether it is hot, but when it begins almost to smoke, it's hot enough. If you put your scallops into a cool pan, they're not going to brown. So I'm just waiting here. When you look and see that it has a very slight movement, it's much easier if you have butter in, because you can tell how it is. Well, I'll just put in one scallop and see. No, see, that isn't hot enough. It isn't making any kind of a noise. But it's always better just to test one rather than put in the whole bunch and then find that they steam. Because when a really good sauté, they get nice and brown, and they none of them stick together, and you can toss them about. Now that smoke from my burner, I dropped some fat on it. I'll put in one more scallop. I think it's beginning to get almost hot enough. Always remember, when you're sautéing, you just wait. I dropped a little oil on the burner when I was... Now that's beginning to make a noise. You can see that? So the fat's hot enough. And in they go. You just toss them around. I've got the heat on very high at this point. Now I'm going to take a look at these stewing ones here. They're only going to take about 5 minutes, and they should cook very slowly. I'm going to put them a little bit to the side there. You just keep tossing these around every once in a while. And now, while these are cooking, I'm going to show you a very quick, easy, and nice accompaniment for them, which are tomatoes a la Provençal. Provençal, as I said, always means oil and garlic, and usually always tomato. And this is terribly quick and nice. You just cut them in half. We're just serving two people, so we don't need very much. And then you squeeze out the juice. You always squeeze out the juice in doing things like this, so you get awfully gooey, gooey tomatoes, and we don't want that. There. You see, when you're doing a sauté, you just keep watching and just tossing them around. And then the tomatoes go into our pie plate, and we're going to cover them with breadcrumbs and garlic and parsley. And this is I'm going to show you a very quick way to make breadcrumbs. in the electric blender. You probably, most of you know this, but I run into people that don't realize all the wonderful things you can do with the blender. I've got two slices of a homemade type of bread. Don't get that Kleenex kind that you can squeeze in your fingers meat, because it doesn't give enough body. There it is, just turn it on full. And there you are. That goes into a little bowl. Then we have chopped parsley. Keep watching the scallops here. Did that a little too high. You get your parsley all lined up. And just chop it. And then hold your knife like that and just go back and forth. I think I have a little bit too much bread crumbery in here, so I'm going to take some of it out. We want just enough to cover these. Now, I think that's going to be enough. And then put in some parsley. And then, well, this is the French chef's way of crushing garlic. They don't use garlic presses. They don't seem to like all these modern things that we do. You just lay it on your board and take your knife and go whap, and then chop it up like that. As a matter of fact, it's usually better because it's a little wet. Put some parsley in with it. Now, if you don't happen to like garlic, you can always use some scallions or shallots. There. And then we want a little bit of olive oil, or you can use melted butter if you don't like olive oil. And a little bit of salt. I'm putting in about a quarter teaspoon. And a little bit of pepper. And there are tomatoes. I'm going to put a little tiny bit of salt in the tomatoes like that. And then stir it all up with a rubber spatula or a spoon. And then just fill your tomatoes with it. We'll divide it up in four. That's a good thing if you have some things to put on other things. And there's six things. Divide your bowl into six pieces, and then you won't run out. That smells good. I just love garlic. We used to live in Marseille, and I guess I took a great feeling for it there. They consider it one of the best medicines. If you're ever not feeling well, they always suggest that you take garlic soup. And there, those are all done and ready, and you can just set them aside and broil them whenever you want. I keep keeping an eye on our, I'm going to set them aside here. Now our scallops are done. See, that doesn't take very long. And if we want some more garlic, we can do the same kind of an arrangement of chopped parsley and chopped garlic. And just when the scallops are done, see, that only took about 3 minutes, you pour in the parsley and garlic and then just do like that. Oh, those smell good. Now, I think it'd be nice to put a little bit of butter on. That is permissible even in Mediterranean cooking. You can also add a little butter to the oil. Just let it bubble up there. And watch that. See, that butter is foaming up. That's one of those ways that we've said that you could tell whether your pan was hot when the butter was foaming. There. And just pour it over the scallops. There. Now, doesn't that look like a nice dish? And now, our stewed scallops are done. And I'm going to put these aside. And we're going to make our sauce. And this is going to be one of the fundamental French sauces. It's called a velouté de poisson. And a velouté just means a white meat or fish stock, and a roux, which means butter and flour cooked together. And it's very much like a bechamel sauce. And it's one of the fundamental sauces in French cooking. They call it une sauce mère, or one of the mother sauces. Now, these have only cooked about 5 or 6 minutes. You don't want to overcook them. And you just pour them out. Make sure I get them all out now. And then pour the juice back into your saucepan. And then we want to boil that down, which you always do in French. And when you're making a French sauce, you boil down what you've cooked the things in. There's our little parsley thing. You see how easy that is to get out. And then we're going to make the base for our sauce. And this is going to be how to make a roux. And this takes, we're going to have, let's see, we're just serving 4 people. And we want about 1.5 cups of sauce. And by the time this makes about 1.5 cups or slightly more, so you want about an equal amount of sauce. So that would be either 1.5 to 2. And this is going to be a sauce enriched with cream and egg yolks. So you want to start it out fairly thick. And you want 2 tablespoons of flour per cup of liquid. So I'm going to make it 1.5 cups of sauce, so I will have 3 tablespoons of flour. We want it fairly thick at first because we're going to add cream to it. And so if you're going to add cream to anything, you make it thick at first. Now when that has just melted, we put in our flour. Now this sauce is differently made than many American sauces, only in that you always cook the flour and the butter together. And the point of cooking the flour is so that you don't get that awful pasty taste of a terrible floury sauce. And when the flour and butter are cooked together, that takes out that raw taste of the flour. And when you've reduced your cooking liquid, that gives you a wonderful taste to your sauce. And just remember that if you run into any recipes that say, melt the butter, stir in the flour, and then blend in the liquid. Remember that rather than doing that, if you just cook the flour slowly for about 2 minutes, you're going to get a much smoother and nicer tasting sauce. I don't know why a lot of these recipes don't tell you to cook it. Maybe they think we're all too stupid and we burn the flour. I don't know. But it certainly makes a lot of difference in the taste of the sauce. Now, if you look at this, you'll see that the flour and butter are beginning to froth very slightly together. And they should do that for 2 minutes. And you don't want the flour to turn any more than sort of a buttery golden color. That in French is called a white roux or a roux blanc. There, now after 2 minutes, and your sauce has reduced a bit and taken on a concentrated flavor, you take your pan off the heat and wait until it stopped bubbling. And as soon as it stopped bubbling, you take all of your hot liquid here and pour it in all at once. And then beat it with your wire whip and bring it back up to the simmer. And once you've cooked your flour and reduced your stock, you don't have to do any of this long simmering of a stock because the flour has been cooked and the stock has been reduced, and all it needs to do is to come up to the boil and boil for just about a minute. You see, it's already getting thick there, which is just what we want. And we're going to enrich this with cream and an egg yolk. There, now it's boiling. You see, that does it very quickly. Be sure that you use a heavy bottom pan on this, and also any pan in which you're doing a sauce that has white wine and or egg yolks, be sure that you use either a stainless steel or a porcelain pan. If you use some other types of metal pans, will stain the sauce grayish and sometimes turn the egg yolks greenish. Now that's boiled enough, and you see that's very thick, so we can add just as much cream as we want, practically. And now I'm going to take that off the heat, and we have our egg yolk and 2 tablespoons of cream here. Anytime you are going to enrich a hot sauce with egg yolks, you always mix the egg yolk with a cool liquid, in this case cream, and then you pour just a few drops of your hot sauce in like that, and then beat it up. The idea here is that you don't want to scramble your egg yolk. You just put in a little more. This is when the egg yolk is just very gradually heated up. That's all you need. There, now that's heated up enough so we can pour it in a thin stream. Always remember this whenever you have to do a sauce like this, that you gradually beat your hot sauce into your egg yolks. There. Now this comes back over heat and we want it to come to the simmer again, and the egg yolk won't scramble because you've combined the yolk and the sauce correctly. And when an egg yolk is in contact with a flour-based sauce, such as a velouté, it's not going to scramble if you've done the preliminaries correctly at first. Then as soon as that comes up to the simmer, you add a little bit of cream. And if you're going to add a cream to a sauce, just add it a little bit at a time. Just a little bit more in. We want the sauce to be thick enough to coat the spoon. You see, when I hold the spoon up, the sauce coats it nicely like that, which means that it will also coat the scallops when it's added to it. If you have too thin a sauce, it just falls away from the scallops and looks very messy. And now we shall pour the sauce onto the scallops. Another rubber spatula. I don't know what I'd do without a rubber spatula. There. And now mix it all together. And taste it for seasoning. I want to be sure that it's right at this point. Well, that's awfully good, I must say. And now we put the sauce into the scallops. We put the scallops into the buttered. These are buttered shells. These you can get at your hardware store or fish market, usually. And if you can't get them, get just any kind of a little fireproof dish. These hold about 1/2 cup. Or you can put the whole thing into a big, large, oven-proof dish. We had these so that they could be for individual servings. There. And then put a little bit of grated cheese on, and they're ready for the broiler. This is grated Swiss cheese. There. And now into the broiler, where they're just going to brown the top for about a minute. Have the broiler hot and keep your eye on it. Now you can get all of this ready ahead of time, get all the cheese on and everything, and then refrigerate them until you're ready to broil them. And if they're cold and refrigerated, you'll have to put the broiler on rather low so that they can just heat through. But they should be bubbling in the top brown. If you get it too close to the broiler when they're cold, You just brown the top, and then you have cold scallops down at the bottom. That's your only problem in doing it ahead of time. Now, let's see how they are. You have to keep your eye on. That's doing very nicely. I remember the first time I ever did some cooking, I read a cookbook about broiling chicken, and it said to put the chicken in the broiler and turn the broiler on and broil for half an hour. So when I came back, it was just black. I don't know why they didn't tell me to keep looking at them, but they didn't. There, that's almost done. You can see how quickly done that was. We've done three recipes in just no time at all. And the wonderful thing about these is that you can get the whole preparation done ahead of time, as I said, and then put it in the icebox. So if you're having a fancy dinner, there's nothing nicer than having little individual dishes of gratinade, coquilles St Jacques à la Parisienne. Now, that's just about it. And one thing about doing any kind of a dish like this, do not keep it hot after it's ready to be served. As you can see, it only takes you 2 or 3 minutes. And then as soon as it's done, take it out and serve it. Things like this just get ruined if they're overcooked. These are just delicious now. There. And we're all ready for dinner, and I'm just about to get people in. And these are a first course, and we're having with them a chilled white Burgundy wine, which goes extremely well with them. Now, it's amazing to think that we got all of that done in just about 20 minutes. We had sautéed scallops, and you remember with the sautéing, you flour them just before you're going to sauté them. And then you get your oil or butter very hot and shake the pan. And don't crowd the pan. If you're going to do a big batch, you'd have to do them in two. And for the sauce that we made for the scallops, I didn't give any real proportions because that's the kind of thing that isn't very important except for how thick the sauce is. And next time we're going to do quiche Lorraine and French pie crust dough. That's all for today on The French Chef. Goodbye. This is Julia Child. Bon appétit.
Julia Child is co-author of Mastering the Art of French Cooking. Accessories and furniture, courtesy of Design Research Incorporated. This has been a WGBH videotape production. The preceding program was made possible with the assistance of a grant from S&H Green Stamp.